Hi, I'm Charlie from African Energy, and welcome to part two of updating your firmware on the WeCo 5K3. In part one, I took you to the WeCo website, to their download area, where you downloaded the hex file and the WeCo tools file. These two files you're going to need for updating the firmware on the battery. In order for you to update the firmware, you're going to need a Windows-based laptop. Plus, you're going to need a USB to serial cable. We call this the ZTEC cable, and it's available from our depots throughout Africa. Before you upgrade the firmware, make sure that your battery is switched off. Then take the RJ45 end of your cable and put it into the RS232 socket on the side of the battery where we would normally fit our Wi-Fi unit. Then you take the USB part of the cable, plug it into your laptop, and then turn the battery on by holding the button down for half a second. The green light will start flashing, and in a few seconds the relay of the battery will engage. Now that we've connected the WeCo battery to the laptop, go to the folder where you extracted the two files from video one, and if you go to the WeCo tools folder, you'll find the WeCo tools exe file. Double click on this, and we're greeted with the WeCo software page where we have operator access. From the WeCo software screen, you're going to see operator access, and below that is a bar where you're going to have to enter a password. The password is 1010, and then you hit the enter button. This comes up with the WeCo main screen. Move across to the module setting program. Once the module setting program opens, you will need to go to the COM port and select a COM port. In my case, it's COM5, and we're going to try and connect to the battery. And now we are fully in with the battery. We can see the status of charge. We now need to search for the new firmware for upgrading the battery. In the folder where we extracted the file, it's the 5K3 hex file. We load it, and we will now try and load the firmware. Hit load firmware, it comes up with a warning to say pay attention. We don't need to have any cables or anything disconnecting while this happens, or the upgrade will fail. So we push the open the file. We've heard that the relay has disconnected, and we can see from the screen that the firmware is loading. And once the firmware is loaded, the relay will click back on. Okay, so we've come up with a firmware update success box. We click OK. And we should hit that tree relay click in. And we're now up to version 6.28. So the firmware has been updated from 9.07 to 6.28, which is a higher dated firmware. So we can now disconnect from the software, and the battery firmware has been successfully updated. If you have multiple batteries, you will need to make sure that you update the firmware on all of them before you try to parallel them. This is Charlie from African Energy. Thanks for joining us on this video.